Good morning. You're watching Proactive London. I'm joined this morning by Ajan Reginald, newly appointed CEO at Roquefort Therapeutics. Good morning, Ajan. How are you?
Very well, thank you, Chris. Good morning to you.
Thanks very much for joining us. You must be a very busy man because your release is literally hot off the presses in the past couple of hours, announcing your completed acquisition of Oncogeni and also successful fundraising, just over £1 million from placing. You must be a very happy chap.
Yes, you know, it's a tough market. So we're delighted to be able to both complete the transaction and complete the fundraising in a challenging market. I think that potentially speaks to the innovation that we're hoping to bring forward and to the confidence our investors have in the team's ability to execute in, you know, in this biotech and pharma field where we have expertise.
Absolutely. Now, I know that materially this means an exciting change for Roquefort in the area of oncology. Could you possibly expand on that for our viewers and let us know how the additional secured funding is going to be rolled out?
Yes, absolutely. So over the last 6 months, Roquefort's completed a strategic review and decided to focus in oncology. That's because oncology is a market where it's the fastest growing market in biotech and pharma. And we believe our assets, our programs are uniquely positioned to be potentially first in class. That means that they would be the first medicines of this type in their field. And that has great potential benefits for patients where, you know, we're hoping to treat the patients that have the most difficult to treat cancers, but also for shareholders that potentially brings, you know, high commercial value in niches which are at the moment not well treated.
Now, in your portfolio, I notice, of course, you have four patented programs. Can you just let us know a bit about how Oncogeni is going to prove a good fit to complement those?
Yes, absolutely. I think what's critical with a small biotech company is to have a high degree of focus. So what we've been able to do by bringing in the Oncogeni programs is to bring in highly complementary technology. All four programs are focused in oncology, and even within oncology, they're focused on hard to treat cancers. We've got antibodies, we've got cell and gene therapies. And these are areas where we have a lot of expertise and areas where patients, even though we've made significant advances over the last 20 years, there are still areas where patients are not seeing optimal treatment. So our hope is to be able to move these novel, innovative new medicines forward to help patients in, as I mentioned, what is the fastest growing market in biotech and pharma.
Also, I noticed in the news out today about the statement about your significant state-of-the-art laboratory and manufacturing facility. This must be a very solid base for the company's continued success going forward, in addition to the Oncogeni acquisition.
Yes, I mean, I think it goes to your comment about being a material company. Yeah, we have the scientists, we have the infrastructure, the laboratories to be able to do the right experiments and to design the right experiments. We have a portfolio of products, and we have a focus strategy, which again is to treat those hard to treat cancers, which is a very attractive market to look at. Oncology market is growing very, very quickly. It's the fastest growing market in biotech and pharma, and it's certainly one where we feel we can hopefully help patients in the future and therefore grow our market.
And it seems to me from one of the statements in the release, you've got the double whammy here because you've announced Nobel laureate Professor Sir Martin Evans coming on board as Group Scientific Officer, and also Dr. Darren Disley, both coming into the fold. Can you let us know a little bit more about their backgrounds and the experience they're going to bring to Roquefort?
Yes, absolutely. Both exceptionally experienced scientists, but as relevant, their ability to develop drugs. So we've been working, Martin, myself and Darren have worked together for over a decade, and we've been able to move drugs from the same point we have at Roquefort. So from this very early preclinical development, we've been able to take drugs through into the clinic. And that process of taking very early innovation, very cutting edge innovation, and taking it towards the clinic is how you create value for shareholders, and ultimately how we hope to be able to bring medicines to market to help patients.
So I say overall exciting news. You did touch on the fact that it is a challenging marketplace at the moment, but I'm sure there's renewed confidence in Roquefort's future given this addition to the family. What kind of progress do you expect to make in the next 6 months? What's up for you for the end of the year and into 2023?
Yes, I mean, I think irrespective of market conditions, we're an innovation-based company. As you've mentioned, we have Nobel laureate, we have scientists with great experience on how to develop drugs. Value creation in biotech and pharma is precisely about developing drugs. It's about taking early innovation, which is potentially a scientific breakthrough, and converting that into a medicine that can actually help patients. I think if we deliver on that, we would hope to see a value increase for shareholders and ultimately for our constituent patients. Over the next 6 months, we hope to be able to report progress in our different programs. And as we've mentioned, our goal is next year to be able to have at least one program ready to go into human trials.
Well, it all sounds very exciting. And obviously, when you're dealing in the field of medicine with such dangerous diseases as cancer, it's all very encouraging for the patients out there, as well as the people involved in the investment. So in the meantime, we wish you all the very best of luck down there and hope you will keep us updated as progress moves on in the next 6 months and into next year. In the meantime, Ajan Reginald, new CEO at Roquefort Therapeutics, thank you very much for your time today at Proactive London.
Thank you. Good morning.